We are surrounded by air from all the directions. This envelope of air around us is what we call atmosphere. Does air also exert pressure on objects on the Earth? In our previous video, we studied that the liquid exerts pressure in all directions. For example, here we have the water in a beaker. Due to gravity, this water is pulled down towards the Earth. If we divide this water into different layers, then each layer is being pulled down by the Earth. Due to this pull, water exerts downward pressure, and this pressure is uneven throughout. That is, the bottom layer experiences more pressure than the top layer. This is because the weight of water above the bottom layer is more, and the pressure decreases as we go upwards. In fact, we saw that the water exerts pressure in all directions and not only in the downward direction. One more thing that we studied about the liquid pressure is that at any point in a liquid, the pressure is the same in all directions. That is, if I take any point here in this water, the pressure exerted by water here is the same in all the directions. Air also behaves in the same way. Just like water, air is also being pulled down by the Earth's gravitational force. This force applies pressure on the air in the downward direction. The pressure exerted by air is called air pressure or atmospheric pressure. Did you know that the atmosphere is divided into different layers? The atmosphere is divided into 5 layers, namely the troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. The pressure in the troposphere, which is the bottommost layer, is higher than the pressure in the layers above it. And I'm sure you can guess the reason why. This is because the weight of the air above the troposphere is greater than the weight of the air above, say, the stratosphere. The air pressure also acts in every direction and not only in the downward direction. And finally, just like the pressure in liquids, the air pressure at a particular height above the Earth's surface is same in all directions. That is, if I take these 2 points at the same distance above the Earth's surface, then the air at this point will exert an equal pressure in all the directions, just like the air at this point. Let's look at an interesting graph now. A graph which represents pressure at a particular altitude. The graph also represents how the pressure varies from layer to layer. The troposphere layer is closest to the surface of the Earth, and the pressure in this layer goes up to 100,000 Pascal, where Pascals, represented by Pa, is the SI unit of pressure. This is massive pressure. This pressure pushes and pulls the object on the surface on the Earth. For example, if I take a table with the upper surface of 1 by 1 meter, the pressure exerted by the air on the table in the downward direction is greater than 1 lakh pascals. This is equivalent to 10 cars being put on this table. Yes, 10 cars. I know what you must be thinking. Why doesn't this surface collapse under this huge pressure? How does it handle such massive pressure acting down on it? A little while ago, we said that the pressure exerted at points above the Earth's surface is equal in all directions. So the pressure at every point on the table is the same in all the directions. That is, if downward pressure is pushing the table surface with a great force, then the upward pressure is also pushing it in the upward direction with the same force. Both the forces are balanced and the table does not collapse. As I said, pressure is not only acting in these 2 directions, it is acting on the surface in all the directions. Pressures acting in opposite directions cancel each other out. Here is one cool experiment that you can also perform at home. Take a plastic bottle filled with water. Take a cardboard paper and place it on the open end of the bottle like this. Hold this paper with your hand so that it does not move from its position and invert the bottle. Now let go of the paper. What did you see? The cardboard paper sticks to the surface. Why is it held to the surface? It is held to the surface because of the air pressure that is pushing the paper in the upward direction. The upward air pressure is sufficient to counter the downward push exerted by the water. Now make few holes in the bottle at its base. What happens now? Why did the paper fall off? Did the upward pressure on it stop acting or did it reduce in the value? No, it didn't. The upward pressure on it by the air remains the same, but the downward pressure increased in its value. When we made holes in the bottle, we allowed air to flow inside it from the top. The air from the top started exerting pressure on the water. The combined pressure of water and air from top could easily overcome the pressure exerted by air from the bottom. Hence, there is net force acting on the paper in the downward direction. That is, there is more pressure in the downward direction. That is the reason why this paper gets detached from the surface.